its water volume system. But when Petit fancied this mother's old round dolls, which she observed with mothballs for the little girl she expected to have, his father was excessively masculine, from the low-browed forehead and the thick pashables to the wide cleft chest and rich abdomen beneath. As in photos of his left leg, which has rheumatic attacks that rendered him almost useless, only goaded him to assert his maleness by extravagant display of superiority. "Well, call him boy. Here's my son, a male, the offspring of a male." Dog and Dog told his wife in a tone as crowing as a rooster's after pecking a hen. "A man is fostered by heredity and environment. I've given him enough rat for his blood, but the lot of good it will do him with the kind of environment you're giving him. Don't tell me, baby." As he gave him the tongue, he just happened upon it to my apartment when I was hearing him. He took pity and even threw me down. He said it looks very unhappy because it is naked and lonely. He asked me to make a dress for it.
"And you made one. You encouraged him to play with it."
Dona and Chaynovic has been embarrassing. I had many dumb things and I thought I would make use of them, she said, brushing an imaginary curl with her hair in his forehead. And it is still a smooth forehead, clean swept and unlined. It doesn't match the tired blue of her eyes, nor the blue of her head now. Dog and Dog saw the forehead and the gestures, took it in a quiver of the delicate nostrils and a simple dimple in her cheek.
"You're such a child yourself, Adrian. You still want to play with dogs. That's why, I suppose, you refuse to let your sons hear my truth."
His eyes hardened and the pole stick in his right ear.
"No, I will not allow it,"
he said, struggling in his feet with his hand and shouting,
"Boy, boy, boy."
The boy was getting the doll ready for bed in a wigwam of coconut fronds he had made in the yard below. The doll was long, slender, round-bodied, with a glossy head of porcelain. His father's stentorian voice drew his brows together. At home was his father's shouting down. His father was only shouting at you. How could his father stand him?
"Boy! Boy! Boy!"
came his father's voice again. The boy took the doll and walked hastily towards the house. His father and mother met him at the head of the stairs. The boy looked at his father's angry face and said without flinching, "Where are you calling me, father? My name isn't Boy."
"It is Boy from now on. That will help you to remember that you are a boy. A boy! Understand?"
Don and Don thundered at him and snatched the dog and flung it viciously to the floor. When he was 19, he told his father that he wanted to be a priest. But his father said,
"A priest? Is that all you want to do? America? Assisi? Half man? I'd rather you die. I'd rather I die.